You interested in a cheap, easy way to anodize titanium? I'll show you how up next. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name's Brian, and I do a lot of titanium anodizing. And I show you guys how to do titanium anodizing at home for next to no money. If that's something that interests you, please consider subscribing. Now on with the video. I'm sure you guys have seen this method done before and wondered how it's done. I was prepping this knife for an even cooler method of anodizing. I'll be showing you in the next video. But in this video, we're just going to keep it simple. So we're going to do it on the back of the knife here. So I've heard this method of anodizing called snake anodizing or line anodizing. Whatever you want to call it, I'm sure you've seen it before. So I'm going to show you guys how to do it. Really simple stuff. So the first thing you need to do is prep your metal. So I've already prepped this. The way I prepped this, I just scuffed it with some 400 grit. You want to go in one direction so you don't leave swirls. And then give it a good wipe down. I'm wiping this down with some isopropyl alcohol. I've used acetone to wipe it down in the past, but I've heard other people say that sometimes acetone will leave a film on the piece. So isopropyl alcohol works just fine. Honestly, I thought acetone worked fine for me too, but personal preference. Wipe it down though. Make sure you get any skin oils off of the piece, because otherwise you're going to leave weird marks on your piece after you anodize. And then I always wear gloves so I don't leave any more marks on there. So now that the piece is ready to go, if you plan on keeping your anodizing, I do recommend etching with the Whink prior to anodizing. And if you watch my how to anodize tutorial video, it walks you through every step of normal anodizing procedures. So if you were going to use the Whink, just a quick 10 seconds in the Whink and you're good to go. Just be careful with this stuff. It's a very diluted hydrofluoric acid. I believe it's somewhere around 3%, but it is still hydrofluoric acid. So make sure you wear gloves, eye protection, all the proper PPE. Just be safe, guys. If you are interested in picking up some of this Whink and need to know where to get it, I've linked a Amazon link in the description. If you use that link, you'll actually be helping support the channel. It doesn't cost a dime extra for you. They help support the channel with it. So I'd appreciate it if you could use the link. That'd be great. So our piece is ready to go. Now all we need is just a regular sheet of computer paper. And we're going to cut that to roughly the size of the scale. Doesn't really matter how big it is. I just a little easier to work with when it's about the size of the scale. And since I'm terrible at freehand drawing, I'm gonna use the straight edge and make some lines on this paper. You don't need to make the lines. It's just easier for me to follow a line if I draw it on here first. Once you've got your pattern decided on your paper, you've got it drawn on there if that's how you choose to do it. Get our piece ready here. And take your piece of paper. Okay, now you're going to want to get something that your paper will fit in. All right. Pour distilled water into it, and then mix a spoonful of baking soda in with that. So baking soda, pour it in, and then stir it up till the baking soda dissolves. Some guys use TSP. You know, I've never had an issue with baking soda. The baking soda works just fine for me. If you have TSP lying around, I mean, you could use that. It's going to do the same thing. Okay, now that we got that dissolved in there, we're going to set that off to the side. For this, I want a blue color, so I'm actually going to be using 3 9-volt batteries put in series. And then you're going to need your positive and negative alligator clips, so you can get that stuff ready. Red to positive, black to negative. Now that we've got that all set to go, we're going to take our piece of paper and we're just going to put it in the water. Let that soak up. And while that's soaking, get our piece, and we're going to connect the positive alligator clip to our workpiece. All right, so we've got our positive alligator clip on our workpiece. We're going to take this paper that's been soaking, put the paper right over top of your piece of titanium. Then you're going to take your negative alligator clip and you're just going to follow the lines that you made. On the paper. Now pull your leads off. I'll take this back off.
Because I want to try a few more times and see if I can get some different results. This is in real time. Every time I go over the titanium with the alligator clip, I'm doing it in real time to show you what happens at different speeds. Let's try it again. Again, this is in real time. So the slower you go, the darker and fatter the line is. I added this so you can see how quickly the Whink removes the anodizing. Just a few seconds and it's gone. While you're watching this, I'm going to take just a quick second to tell you about my ring shop. Head on over to www.etsy.com/shop/Apollo's Rings. That's APOLLOSRINGS. And consider buying a ring to help support the channel. Lots of carbon fiber options over there, and I'll be adding some vintage micarta here in the near future as well. If you go really fast, you get a really thin, light line. That's it. We'll see you on the next one. Remember to check out that free Amazon Prime trial and like and subscribe. Thanks, guys.